How do I send an email to many people? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got, actually a couple of questions I got some time ago. I've been working on figuring out how to send emails to a large group of people at a time. I have an organization and would like to send weekly emails out to them. Right now I have 1,500 people, but I'm actively signing people up and expect to have several times more over the next couple of months. Another question. When I travel, I send emails to a selection of friends, all of whom have explicitly asked to be on the list of recipients and who presumably therefore do not mark them as spam. But my ISP sees multiple addresses and an overseas IP address, assumes spam, and prevents it from being sent. I've taken it up with them, and their attitude is, your problem, not ours. First of all, thank the spammers for this situation. Because of them, email services, the ones you use to send, as well as those being used by your intended recipients, they've been forced to make things more difficult than, honestly, it should be. What we might do without thinking about it too hard makes us look like spammers. Hence, our messages don't get through, either bouncing, landing in spam folders, or just disappearing entirely. And yeah, it's our problem, not the email services. Don't, number one, don't send to multiple recipients at once. If you want to send a single message to a group of people, it's tempting to just send a message to a group of people. By that, I mean fire up your email and list everyone on the to or CC lines. Email services are more likely to treat your email as spam as a result. Why? Because it's what spammers do. Now, this example has only 10 recipients, but some services will prevent you from sending to that many at once. And even if they do allow it, the receiving service may notice that the number of recipients is 10 and toss that email into a spam bucket. The actual number will vary. It could be less than 10 or it could be more than 10. It's going to vary from email service to email service. Honestly, I start to get concerned when the number of recipients on an email exceeds 5. Don't, number 2. Okay, BCC multiple recipients. One way to sidestep a privacy issue is to use BCC instead. In this case, the email is still sent to all the recipients. You, the sender, sees and fills out the BCC line, but that line is hidden from all the recipients. It's better email etiquette because you're not exposing everyone's email addresses to everyone else, which is considered both rude and a violation of everyone's privacy. Even using BCC, though, two problems remain. Your email provider still sees that you're sending a single message to many recipients at once and might restrict your ability to do so. The recipient's email services may not see who else you're sending to specifically, since BCC hides that. But notice, however, that all of the recipients in my example are using the same email service, askleoexample.com. That email service may notice a sudden flood of identical messages to several of its accounts. Guess what? That looks like spam. So if a large number of real-life recipients share the same email provider, perhaps Gmail or one of the Microsoft-related email addresses, then those services could see it as a flood as well. In short, BCC doesn't help when it comes to getting your email delivered and, honestly, can even hurt. Something to avoid? Free email services. Sending email using a free email service puts you at a disadvantage right out of the gate. A lot of spam originates from them, and as a result, if you use one, it almost acts as a kind of strike against you, particularly if you're sending to a large number of people. Yes, things have gotten better over the years, for sure. Services have made it more difficult for spammers to create large numbers of accounts like they used to, but it's still an issue. I know you love your free email, and you likely rarely see any problems, but it's important to realize that there can be disadvantages, again, particularly when you're sending large quantities of email. Now, there is a painful, what I'll call a painful workaround, smaller batches. One of the solutions that people have suggested and used is to send your email in multiple smaller batches. For example, rather than sending one email to 10 people, you might send 3 separate emails. First to 3, then to 3 more, and then to the final 4. And between those messages, there might be a delay. There's naturally delay, of course, as you do the work. Does that matter? Maybe. If you send several emails in rapid succession, that, too, can look like a spammer at work. Whether or not it factors in is unclear and almost certainly, again, varies depending on the email providers that are involved. I'll admit, it's crude, but it can be effective. And if this is something you're doing rarely, it's a solution you've got right now. All right, let's start talking about real solutions. Groups. Unfortunately, Yahoo Groups is no more, but there are 2 alternatives that you can use to the same effect. Google Groups and Groups.io, which, as I understand it, was created by the engineers originally behind Yahoo Groups. In both cases, what you do is you create a group with the email addresses of the individuals you want to get your messages. They may have to confirm that they want to receive your messages, but that's just good practice, again, to prevent being labeled a spammer. You can then send a single message to the group email address. That service then sends single messages to each of the members of that group. Because it's opt-in by the recipients, and because it's from a service with a good reputation, and because individual emails are sent one-to-one rather than one-to-many, the chances of getting delivered are significantly higher. Google Groups is free, and Groups.io has a free plan. Both have an array of additional features you might find useful for your messages, such as archives and photo storage and more. Honestly, what you've described, especially the 1,500 people and more getting periodic emails from an organization, sounds like a newsletter. So, use a mailing list service. Newsletter sending services are ideal for periodic broadcasts to many recipients. There are many. I'm partial to AWeber, which I've been using for the Ask Leo newsletter from the start, close to 20 years ago. MailChimp might be another you've probably heard of. Even something like Substack these days can be used for this, assuming you don't mind your content being posted publicly. Now, there are some rules. Regardless of the solution you eventually take, there are some important rules you need to follow when you start mass mailing people. Most of these are common sense, and all are important to avoid being labeled a spammer. Others are actually legal requirements, at least in the United States. First, don't add people to your list without their permission. It's the definition of spam. The best way to make sure they want to be on your list is to use what's called confirmed opt-in, which requires that your service send some kind of confirmation email that they respond to before they can be added to your list. Send what you promised and nothing else. If people sign up for email on a certain topic and then you start sending other unrelated messages, that's another definition of spam. Make it easy to leave. One-click unsubscribe might be required if your list is commercial. While it's tempting to keep more subscribers by making it difficult to leave, it actually increases the chance that they will start reporting your email as spam. Besides, do you really want to be pestering people who don't want to hear from you? And be clear in each message about who the message is from. If people don't recognize the email, it's just so much spam to them. Sending bulk email, email newsletters, hosting discussion lists, and anything that results in messages to many people at once requires special consideration. I encourage you to think it through and do it right. So, here are some examples of which of the solutions I use and under what conditions. When sending to many people, I avoid doing it manually on the 2, the CC, or the BCC lines. Like I said, this path leads to spam. I use a Google group for a list of people who've asked to be notified of local corgi-related events. I'm also on a couple of Google groups for local ham radio operators. I manage several groups on groups.io. One is a large corgi discussion list, and the others include a set of discussion and notification lists for one of the nonprofits I support. And I use a formal newsletter sending service, AWeber, to send my Ask Leo and other newsletters. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/130487. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.